we know it, that is their reputation.
And it's completely and utterly wrong.
It's true. Some zombies result of voodoo ceremonies and crave human flesh.
And some bloody vampires sought human blood.
But once they founded their own underground society,
they became harmless to human beings.
Content to eat flesh
and suck the blood
of their environmental food chain.
Rats, mice,
slugs, worms,
beetles, leeches.
In other words,
yuck.
But they were happy in their own little enclosed world,
which was a series of vast hidden catacombs underneath the town of Dewberry.
Until one day a decadent human artifact made its appearance amongst them.
The object that made its way down from the daylight world was a television.
Once they observed the trappings of Western culture,
the pop music, the game shows,
the adverts,
the parts of the Caribbean films, they began to rumble with discontent.
Hey you guys, why don't we have some fun humans?
Right on, man.
I want to taste a Big Mac.
Yeah!
With loads of ketchup. There's only one way. We have to summon the master.
Count Dracula, but we only summon him in emergencies.
We haven't summoned him for over 100 years.
Well, isn't it an emergency? I say to summon the master.
We summon the master. All those in favour say aye.
Aye.
Then let us incant the summons.
Master, master, sleeping sound. In your coffin underground. Show once more your every feature. You're the ultimate night creature. Come to us all gathered here.
Master, master, now appear!
Thank you. Earth?
No, to the surface.
To the world of humans.
Yay!
Yay!
But remember what happened last time you made the robot?
You ate them!
That was over 100 years ago. Lost our taste for them.
Yes, we got you for our diet of unmentionable things.
But the big problem is, how do you mix with humans without getting noticed? Where is it that people dress as women as you lot? The only place I can think of is spectators at a test cricket match.
But you want to join the living, not the big.
I didn't think that would appeal. So, it's time for some lateral thinking.
Duh, what's that?
The opposite of straight thinking.
No, what's being gay?
Forgive me, friends, I've forgotten to obviously away us. But first, you must all promise not to harm the humans, horrible though they are. Do you give me your solemn oath not to eat human flesh or suck human blood?
We do.
What about you, Martin? Do you still think your fangs are the neck of maidens?
Maybe.
That's different. That's expected of me. Ah, I have an idea. Humans enjoy themselves by going to musicals and rock concerts and such like. And they often dress in weird costumes for the occasion.
You mean you're going to take us to Glastonbury?
No, I'll create my own rock band. One so bizarre it makes Iron Maiden look more like maiden art. And its fans will be encouraged to dress and look just as hideous as you bunch of deadbeats. I will need 3 backing girl singers dressed as vampires and a front man who looks like a zombie.
You don't mean?
Yes, a Mick Jagger phone. Friends, your troubles will soon be over.
Yay!
Yay! I will ascend to the surface and assemble a rock group. Once it's up and running, I shall send for you.
Yay!
But where will you get the rock group from?
Easy, auditions. Plenty of wannabe rock stars around these days. And once it's playing, so shall you be. You can mix with the audiences and no one will be any the wiser. And after the shows, you can go out clubbing. No questions asked. What do you say to that?
Let's rock and roll!
By the public. Congratulations and keep up the good work.
Just
thing behind the desk so long I've forgotten to walk.
But it's such an everyday. The fresh air will do us good. And it will remind us how we were starting the force.
You mean walking the bee?
Don't mind me.
Well, I do mine.
I've never known a tea to be punctual.
Well, this is T-3, T-2, T-1, 0.
Good morning, Miss Peterson. Good morning, Quasimodo. However, enough of social pleasantries to work. So, pristine megatons, where's my atom ball?
I threw it out. It was gathering dust.
Hillsbit!
The bells! The bells!
Sorry.
Had your wired skilled hands, that device could detonate. Just in time. In another 5 seconds, it would have exploded. Miss Peterson, be more careful in the future. You could have wiped out half of Yr6.
Would that be such a bad thing?
Bad for us. We'd be in it. Well, never mind. On to my latest masterpiece. When drunk, it completely reverses a person's character. For instance, Quasi, if you were to drink this, you would wear a stupid grin on your face and would want to spread happiness all around. You'd probably become a tap dancer. Want to try it?
No, Ben. You're not getting me to drink it either, but how are you going to use it?
For evil purposes, of course. Quasi, go bring in our criminal friends. This harmless looking concoction will make me the greatest criminal mastermind of all time. Ah, here come some of the finest lonesome villains you could ever hope to meet.
All this way!
Brothers and sisters in crime, time for a monthly accountants. So I shall ask some of you to step forward and state your name, occupation and income from the same over the last month. Fingers!
Fingers Johnson, pickpocket, £3,000 cash and 16 credit cards.
A round of applause for Fingers! Shake a leg!
Shake a leg. I failed all my loans at school because they didn't have any in black men extortion. Anyway, last month I had a cabinet minister, a bishop and a cabinet ministry all stitched up in compromising conversations. Result, £10,000 each.
A round of applause for Shake a leg!
Steroid Stan, Zeus Cannon, Free Lance Hulk, and your favourite frightener. Anything what needs strength, flagging, ripping off secure van doors, carjacking, protection rackets, those are dosh, but I couldn't say how much, because they ain't so good at counting.
Well, I am. Steroid Stan has brought in a staggering $60,000!
On every
assembly rooms.
Watson, I confess, I'm baffled by the strange behaviour of female teenagers.
Are we all?
I mean, those affected by vampires.
Ah, quite so. But why are we just here?
This is a rock venue.
I've observed queues of young girls here. I wonder if there's a connection.
Nonsense, Holmes. Besides, there are young lads as well. They're all waiting for this new group.
Watson, look at that poster.
What's the matter with it?
Maybe the name of it?
Great Scott, Holmes.
No, that's not its name. It's called
the Dracula Rock Show.
Ices, lollies, strings. Get your ices, lollies, strings.
Holmes, that ice cream seller, doesn't he look familiar?
We'll soon see. You better let me to the street vendor's license. I've never heard that before.
I want another sort of monster.
Help! He's the minimum.
I am the police.
Aren't you going to join a thing?
I certainly am. Unless you produce your street vendor's license at the police station within 24 hours. 24 hours, you will be arrested and all of your assets frozen.
I say, Holmes, where are these frozen assets?
Well, spotted, Watson. You fellow, where are your ices, noise and drinks you've been shouting about?
Sorry, Garth, sorry, the Lord. This feel is just a habit.
Well, I don't like the look of you at all.
Just what my wife keeps saying, sir.
In fact, I think I... Watson, hold him! Moriarty!
Thanks, we meet again.
Thought I'd take down 7 years.
They led me out early, overcrowded, so many pensioners and motorists in. They had to release all the real villains. So I thought I'd come and renew our acquaintance and tell you that my empire's up and running again. Don't you think you can get the better of me a second time?
I say that is a blow, judge about you once.
Not a blow, it's merely a revel in your forthcoming downfall, which may be sooner than you think.
By the way, you and your constables are welcome to those trains. Think of it as a toast before the battle commences.
Well, it looks like we're in for a busy time with Moriarty and a possible vampire on the loose.
Let's drink to Stoutful.
Don't slow shit. Cheers.
Down the hatch.
And so the night of the concert dawned.
That's a terrible mixed metaphor.
Nevertheless, a big crowd was present to witness the birth of a new rock sensation.
Swelled by the denizens of the underworld.
Who, as the Count had foretold, went unremarked in the libel crime of youth culture.
The Count himself.
The Count himself played a major part in the proceedings.
On the theory, the best place to hide yourself is in the spotlight.
Hey man, hi.
I don't understand a word that you're saying.
This is the afterworld.
It's changed since I last saw it.
When was that?
1850. Not sure I like it. All that bright street lighting hurts your eyes.
And all those wonderful characters. They're so noisy and smelly.
So are the crowds.
We'd better all stick together then.
I didn't think this would be your scene, Cosy.
Nonsense. Mrs. B, in my... No. In 1960, I was the area champion at the twist. Trouble is, I think I twisted too much.
Oh, they're never taking you for a rave, Quasi. That's as unlikely as Professor Moriarty showing up.
Professor, what are you doing here?
I thought you were too old for this kind of thing.
Nonsense. My private den have a box collection of games to rap albums. I'm loving it, but I've got to say, it's about time they rang the bells for the start.
The bells! The bells!
Sorry.
Look, it's about to begin.
Welcome to the Dracula Rock Show. I'm your host, Count Dracula.
Yeah.
It's so great to see so many people here and all dressed up for the occasion. a song, which I know is going to be a big hit. Who needs love?
Woo!
That's when I take them and start to strap my stuff like stuff.
Fortunately, the traffic warden recovered.
I also have the forensic results of them drinks that my auntie gave us. They contained a substance that turns one's personality to the exact opposite.
So, if we're drunk in it, I will become a conscientious and loving criminal, and you become... well... sorry. You don't really have that much personality to alter.
True, true. And your whole entire team will turn to lawless bugs.
Some of them were already. But I see how this can help us. Can we alter the colour of the drink without losing its effect?
It's possible. I can give it a go.
Then do it, my dear fellow. That fee Moriarty will find you for a big surprise. Meanwhile, what is Dracula?
He was enjoying himself immensely.
The rock tour is hugely successful and a recording contract imminent.
And with money pouring in, he could indulge himself in every luxury.
But have you ever noticed when you're on the top of the world, things start to go a bit pear-shaped?
The cracks started to appear as a getting liquid.
No way, man. Who starts this outfit? You or me?
Yeah!
We do the gyrations.
And the hip rigging.
But...
me.
It's like Elvis.
Who's more like Johnny Vegas than me?
Anyway, how's the new song coming along?
Don't like it.
What's wrong with it?
I wrote it especially for you. I wrote it especially for you.
I wrote it especially for you.
You and who else?
Sounds like pure ABBA to me.
Yes, there is a difference. But once you put your own style onto it, it'll be great.
You can't be serious.
Come on, all it needs is more rehearsal. Let's give it another go.
Yes, and we'll do the routine with you.
Take it away!
Signing up. Current from extraordinary general meeting.
Yes, we've planned his biggest show ever.
He must be planning something special then.
I'd like to plan something special for you, Mrs. Keaton.
Quasi, you're not suggesting.
I once had a love for a gypsy girl called Esmeralda. I thought I would never get over her, but I've come to realise there's beauty and ugliness, and you're dead ugly.
Why, thank you, Quasi. Pretty grotesque yourself.
Then there's hope for me?
Don't get your hopes too high. I've had two husbands, and I didn't like either of them. Oh, the first was always too subtle. The young boy was pointed to stout. It was furniture polishing. A sad end, but an easy finish.
How? What happened to your second husband?
Oh, he vanished 10 years ago. He said, popping out into the garden to pick some cabbages. That's fast, I thought, but...
How terrible. What did you do?
Opened a tin of peas.
Mrs. Peterson, or may I call you by your first name? What is it, by the way?
Bell.
The bells! The bells!
What's the enough?
Sorry.
What is it with you and the bells, anyway?
I had an unfortunate experience in the bell tower, so I lost my Esmeralda.
How sad. The only bell that drove my first husband mad was the one at closing time. Ah, time's steaming on. Here comes the crowd now.
Bye.
to have him join us on a false emergency at least 10 miles away. And the job shall be done in 30 minutes and we'll be richer beyond our wildest dreams.
I wish I had wildest dreams.
Congratulations, Boy Arty. A master plan. I think a celebration is in order. Watson, bring on the champagne.
We shall return home!
in high spirits as they made their way back to Jewbury.
As they went down through the secret tunnels into labyrinthy depths, they were spotted by the ever-vigilant Holmes.
The last to descend was, of course, Count Dracula.
And as they went down through the tunnels, Holmes followed, prepared to do her duty.
I must admit, it's rather nice to be back. I missed all those little homely jump points. Breakfast in coffin, spending many happy hours poring over my fan collection, and safe and secure in the knowledge that this place is so secret and well hidden that no one will ever find it. Who's there?
Health and safety inspector.
These bureaucrats get everywhere. Come in! Bats, Jesus, the bell!
You must pardon my reception, but I must ask you some questions. Merely for manners, you understand, to eliminate my inquiries.
What inquiries?
Would you just excuse me for a while? I'm repairing my makeup.
A pretty girl in uniform. What more could a red-blooded vampire ask for? Except more red blood.
Thank you.
under the script.
Interesting. I'd like to meet them.
And so you shall. There will be a grand homecoming party to which everyone is invited.
No line dance, I hope.
Certainly not. No One Direction dance.
Then let's go.
But follow me.
Watson, that potion saved my life, but it could be dangerous. I suggest to get rid of it.
Already have. I take the rest of it. The House of Commons water supply.
You know what that means?
Yes. The politicians now always come honest.
No, way worse than that. Now they be
may
even develop brains.
Journey's end.
Full circle.
The zombies and vampires return home,
wishing they'd never left it,
and vowing never to leave it again.
With just the old treat that sent down from up above.
And were only mildly surprised when they received their first visitors straight away. And so, the strange tale ended happily all around.
Which princess must be it?
The zombies and vampires no longer
rumble
with
discontent.
But were at last
happy.
Inspector Holmes' squad and Professor Moriarty's three and four criminals band together in more ways than one.
Guess what, lads?
What?
Our syndicate's won the lotto!
Quasimodo and Mr. Peterson also tied the knot.
You know, by the way, I enjoyed the most.
What?
The bell! The bell!
One Direction. I had to certify him.